As we gear up for the big Thanksgiving meal, we may experiment with a new dish or two or try a twist on an old one. But if you're a food maker, that's standard practice all year long. David Pogue tells us about the Tastemakers tempting America's palate.
Since the dawn of dinner, food fads have formed and fizzled.
Mother Murphy, lucky me. My wife uses Swanson TV turkey dinners.
But who's behind them?
Would they ever come to you and say, hey, you're the trend people. What should we be developing for market next year?
That's what they do all the time.
Sherry Fry is an insights executive at Nielsen IQ in Chicago, a spinoff from the Nielsen TV ratings company. She analyzes the public's food purchases and spots the trends. These days, here's the big one.
Consumers are savvier than ever about what they're putting in their bodies and the impact that it has on their health, but also the health of the planet overall.
Not all of the trends will strike you as obvious, like the spike in mushrooms.
We're seeing this in beverages. We're seeing it in baked goods, shiitake salad dressing.
And sea vegetables.
It's time to eat more kelp.
Kelp burgers and just a variety of seaweed chips and snacks that we're finding.
And ingredients thought to lower your stress levels, like ashwagandha.
So it's possible that in 2024, I might see a favorite sports drink now with ashwagandha.
You already do. Yes.
When a food company embraces a trend by introducing a new product, here's a big secret. Sometimes they outsource the recipe.
I would imagine that DiGiorno or Mrs. Fields has their own chefs, but obviously you're helping them out.
Sometimes they're trying to get into new space and they don't know quite how to do that. And they'll come and ask for our help.
Why? Because it's often more efficient just to hire Matson, a food development lab near San Francisco.
Yeah, this is the greatest hits hall.
Katie Hagen is Matson's insights executive. But how does Matson know where tastes are going? By watching the young people.
If you ask a Gen Z what's their favorite food, what are they gonna say?
Mexican.
And then second is Chinese.
Yeah.
And you also have a rising Hispanic population in the United States, which feeds into the desire for Latin cuisines as well.
On the day we visited, Matson scientists were working on a new line of protein-infused coffee.
All right, we are starting with pH formulation A. Okay.
It's a lot of trial and error.
And keto empanadas, meaning low-carb, high-fat. Their first attempt wasn't a hit.
Okay, first of all, it's a little mushy. We weren't able to get to the right type of dough.
6 months later.
My colleague here has conducted over 100 different formulas to get to this.
That's really good.
What am I missing because it's keto?
Hopefully nothing.
Well, I don't know about you, but I smell hit.
Matson client Lance Lively works for a precision fermentation startup. He and Matson innovation chief Barb Stuckey served me breakfast.
We are working on the future of food.
Are you telling me this is not real eggs?
The egg that you're eating right now does in fact contain real egg protein, but here's the thing. The egg protein did not come from a chicken.
Nobody in a million years would say this didn't come from an egg.
Our egg protein comes from yeast. No cholesterol and no saturated fats.
So why don't we want the actual chicken eggs?
The way that we need to think about producing food in the future has to change. We're going to have too many humans on Earth, and we're not going to have enough land, we're not going to have enough water.
And so we're able to produce completely indistinguishable products at a fraction of the sustainability impact.
The goal for a new product is awareness and memorability.
That's what Campbell's soups are.
Good.
You know, good, memorable.
Finally, before a new food can become a hit, it has to be advertised.
We have our awards.
Andrew Swinand is the CEO of Leo Burnett in Chicago, the agency behind some of history's most famous ad campaigns.
They're great!
Leo Burnett came up with their great.
From the valley of the jolly,
ho, ho, ho,
green giant.
Jolly Green Giant. So some of the most iconic characters in the industry.
So let's say I've invented a new keto mushroom-based lemonade, and I want to hire you.
Decades ago, you would do a TV ad and run it, and you'd be able to reach 50% of the U.S. Today, a lot of it is social.
He means social media. These days, you have to generate buzz online.
It can be difficult to navigate.
For example, to promote Bare Naked Granola, the agency mapped trails that are friendly to naked hikers.
Bare peach check means friendly.
That must have worked on social.
Incredibly successful.
And so, in the new year, the Tastemakers will be giving us food that's healthier and better for the planet, more Mexican and Asian food, and
it is in products across the store.
According to Nielsen IQ's Sherry Fry, more pumpkin spice.
This is a 20-year trend.
But it actually looks like it's still going up. When does it peak?
We're asked this every year about what's happening with pumpkin spice. I think we're all wondering if there'll ever be a point that it'll peak.
Would someone explain this? People make fun of pumpkin spice.